You might want to turn that off. There you go.
That must have took a lot of memory.
Well, the time to get it from hard drive to memory and then process what it needs to do, that's about the limitations of the CPU, but gives you an idea of how slow things were compared to today's systems.
But to them, that was fast.
I wouldn't say fast. It's a kid's game. But Excel spreadsheet, you know, it was just running about the same speeds and processing. And that was the reason why you wanted to have a 287 if you were doing spreadsheets.
Yeah.
Math coprocessor. There are a few games that use the math coprocessor, but...
So, I can give you a master lock.
Oh.
And...
Huh? Loop.
So...
Yeah?
Oh, I was just telling him that, I give him a...
And he goes back to sleep and you can play the game over again.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, wide awake?
E.T. phone home.
And then he snoozes out. There he goes.
You never? Oh my gosh, seriously?
So all you can do is hit escape. Escape. Here, we'll just shut the system down. I gotta park the hard disk before we put it away, but...
What is it? Is it in drive right now then?
Hmm? No, the hard disk. So on the hard disk, you have a head. And this is a stepper motor, so it doesn't auto park when the power shuts off.
I know, but that's what the joke was. You said I have to park it. And I said, what? Is it in drive right now?
I guess you could say it. So basically, parking the head means putting the head in a place where there's no data. So when it's shut off and the head is on the platter, it can be bounced around without damaging anything.
Oh, okay.
Needs to shut off for a little longer before I can turn back on. But yeah, you guys can play with it. There should be DOS on there. There's a couple games. But when you're done, I'll park the heads.
Are you hearing the album?
Drew, that smoke.
What's up, Chief?
Monkey the Chief.
I got this machine from Avery. There's a Sun. Sun Ultra 1. And I have the Ultra 2 up here from Polyhead. There's the Ultra 2, so I now have the set. And here's it running right now. He restored this. Avery restored this all up, got it running. I put in a graphics card, some memory. I think we're trying to hook up the Ethernet cable now because then we can get it online.
Hi, I'm the guy who fixed this machine. So it cost about $500 to get this thing up and running again.
Tell me what it took you, not money-wise, but efforts.
It took a lot of going around eBay and...
So how hard was it to put the parts in and actually install the OS?
Finding the OS was the hard part.
You had help from another person?
I had help from another person. He purchased the mouse, the keyboard. I purchased the he also purchased the disk drive. This is a 50-pin SCSI.
Oh, wow, that's fast.
Yeah.
Oop, I didn't get that on camera. Let me try that again.
Ultra fast.
Look how fast that is.
50-pin SCSI.
I wish it made drives this fast. Look at that. That's fast.
Yeah. So, It's So basically, originally this machine would have been used for analog video editing, 3D animation.
Do you have a demo or something you can show me?
Yeah, I have some demos.
All right, I'll keep this rolling here. What can you show me?
Let me pull up the, I don't want to close it. I want to minimize. There we go. Okay, so can you snag me a chair? Oh, here we go. Because I need to be able to concentrate.
Got a projector on, it looks like. Well, yeah, projecting nothing.
I think it's in sleep mode.
Okay, I'll close the door.
All right, so here we have applications, folders, file management. Okay, and in here I have a folder called pictures. And in there I have some furry art.
Okay, go ahead and show it.
I'm trying to pick.
Don't worry about the content. Just let it go. If you got something iffy there.
This one.
Oh, wow, look at those feet.
Look at that detail.
Oh, man.
This was, okay, by the way, this was manufactured in 1995 when this computer was made.
Wow, you got a lot of foot stuff on here. Oh, boy.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. I'll make sure this is age appropriate on my YouTube.
And then I guess we have a little picture of a furry icon.
More paws. I love paws.
I like those too. Let's see. We have this one. So basically, I just put these on here to demonstrate that yes, this thing can do 3D as well as just regular.
Is there any video?
There is on one of the discs.
Okay.
You want me to pull that out?
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright, let me get the... What is the big box that had everything in it?
The box I gave you? Oh, that box is right down there. Oh, it moved. It's over here, behind here.
Okay. So in here, we have Solaris 8. This is Solaris 8. I believe this is the European, or not European, North Korean copy. So there's that one. And then we have another one. This one is the American. Nope, this one is the Korean copy. Look, this is how you can tell.
Okay.
So it's got Korean text. This is the American one. So in here, there's a thing called documentation. That's the name of the disc.
Okay.
It's called documentation. It would be, I think it would be in here. So it's, one of these ones. Here it is. The flash update ID prom. So, and the way that it opens video is not too different from the way we open video nowadays, except it uses what's called Java Player. And if any of you know what Java Player is, it I think it became Winamp.
Okay.
It's got a noisy disk drive. That might have happened when we dropped it.
Okay. Yeah, I beefed it up a little, but that's okay. I don't mind it being shipped up.
Yeah. Except I think it's having trouble reading the disk.
Is it just a SCSI, you said?
Yeah. It's
a 50, I have extras.
It's a 50-pin.
If we need to replace it, I have extras in here. Yeah, one of these will work. These are all SCSI. Do we need to replace that drive? We can do another video later if it's not working. You must have dropped it hard.
It fell directly out of the back of the thing just after he opened it. Because we weren't back there. He just pulled the thing. You know, he pulled the...
Yeah.
Push the button or whatever, however they do it now. And it just opened the back and here comes the thing.
Yeah.
Well,
that's okay. We could try. I'm surprised the hard drive is still good. You know, usually the hard drive would go before that goes.
The hard drive in this is also kind of unusual in the way that it's made. It's this big old block, and I should probably pop the top on this to show you. I just need one screwdriver to unscrew the one of the screws on here to demonstrate what the inside looks like. Actually, two screws. Yeah, two screws.
Okay, we'll do a part two on this.
Yeah. Later. Can we do that when I've sobered up a bit?
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I was thinking too.
Because I don't want to be messing with
this. Okay. So that was just show you the after con party we're having.
Oh wait, there's one last thing.
All right.
This is the picture, the 3D rendering I did for you.
Okay.
This is Star Office 5.
It's named Baby Pamper Chew. Yeah.
So right now it's loading the 3D space.
Oh, that is so cool. That was cool. Does it do? Can you rotate them and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that'll be in part two. Thank you for doing that. That's wonderful.
You're welcome.
Ah, cute. All right. Hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching. There will be a part two on this.